guys, Glenn here. The fine folks at NewX sent me this NME5 from NewX, the Trident. Yep. They contacted me. They said, hey, Glenn, would you do a review on our new pedal? I'm like, yeah, send it on. And they did right away. So let's open up this box, see what's included. And I'll tell you a little bit about this unit and go over the software and all that stuff. I'll do a series of videos. But this first one is basically just to show you what's inside the box, what you get, and have a look at all the software. So let's take a look. Okay, so let's take a look at this box. First of all, the packaging is just beautiful, man. So there's everything. The unit here is very sturdy. Solid metal chassis. They give you these little button toppers here, which is nice. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of them. So probably want to put them on the top row, maybe. I don't know. And a booklet, which is nice because a lot of companies don't include that. You know, you can look at this online, but it's nice to have a booklet right there. And let's take a look at this box here. Let me show you all of these features here that are included in this thing. First of all, impulse responses. You have 27 built-in cabs with 4 microphones and 3 different positions. And you can also load your own impulse responses. When I get into the software, I'll let you know how many slots you can have, but I believe it's a lot. And their brand new amp modeling technology, TSAC 4K amp modeling. It's their proprietary algorithm, and they claim that it's supposed to give the modeling unprecedented amount of resolution. So we're going to find that out. It's intuitive control layout. I'm going to go over all the controls. You've got a pre and post looper. You can use it as a studio device, and there's plenty of ins and outs. And they have all the common connections that you can use. Now, if we look at the unit itself, you have these dedicated delay and reverb and mod effects. And you have the little screen here. You've got reverb, delay, mod, and effects buttons here. And then you've got the up and down buttons here, and then the A, B, C, and a boost function. Now, if we look at the back, you have an expression pedal jack, which if you wanted to hook up a volume pedal or any kind of other expression pedal. You've got the guitar input. You've got an effects send and return. You've got an auxiliary in. You maybe could use that to play along with some backing tracks. You've got a master volume level knob here. You've got a ground lift. This is nice. Dedicated XLR outs. Balanced XLR outs, which means you won't need a DI box when you go live. Now, normally what I would do is I'd go XLR out into the front of house, and I'd split these output 1 and output 2 lines off onto my on-stage amps. And either 1 or 2 amps. You've got a full-size headphone jack. That's nice. And you've got a power on-off button. Now, these are the MIDI in and out jacks here. And also, it comes with this special MIDI cable. I don't know of any modeling device that includes that. That's good to have. Something extra you don't have to buy. You also get a USB cable. This is a US, this is a US adapter here, which is where we are. So that would just kind of fit on there like so. So there's the power adapter. Okay. So it's the bottom of the unit. Some rubber feet. There's no ventilation needed. Because probably this unit doesn't get very hot, which is nice, especially if you're in a studio situation. You can just leave it on, which most of my stuff, I leave it on all the time. So that's everything that's in the box. Let me just make sure. Yep. It's everything that's included. Now, let's take a look at the software. I'm going to show you what you would need to do to connect this to your computer, which is very important, and I didn't see anybody that showed that. So let's go over into my studio. I'll show you what software you need to get, and we'll connect this to my computer, and we'll turn it on and take a look at the software. Let's go. Okay, guys, so I'm here on the new X website, and I'm going to show you how to connect the Trident to your computer. You're going to go up here to support. First thing you're going to need is the drivers, the ASIO drivers, and here it is for Windows. Now you notice here's Win7 and here's Win10 and 11. I'm on Windows 10. Notice there's not one for Mac. I suspect that it's because you don't need a driver for the Mac operating system, but I'm on Windows, so you'll click on that and you'll save the file to a place where you'll be able to find it. Okay. Next, go here to the firmware and software, and about in the middle of the page, you'll see firmware and software. And now this is, let's see, you're going to scroll down to integrated effects, which is right here. See, integrated effects and Trident Editor Software Windows. Okay. Go ahead and download that where you know you'll be able to find it, okay? I've already downloaded them, so, and here we are. Now, this is the driver, which I've already extracted into this folder. We're going to go ahead and install this. Okay, very easy, very simple. Okay, done. Okay, so I haven't connected the device yet, so I want to exit this one. Yes, okay, I'm going to connect it later. Now let's install the editor, and that would be this. I'm going to go ahead and install this. Okay, now it's going to ask you to connect the unit. So let's go ahead and do that. Okay, I've just connected the unit. And wow, there it is. It's connected. I'll be dogged. There's all the presets. And you've got a ton of presets here. And I recognize you've got some artist presets, but you've also got some custom presets made by some creators. And I recognize some of these names. I'm going to go through some of the presets for you. So now that we've got everything connected, let's take an in-depth look at the software. Okay, guys, so I'm here on the software. I've got it up and running here. I'm going to show you the ins and outs of it. Now, you've got two sides to this. You've got the user side with 96 user slots, okay? And then you have the factory side that has 96 factory presets that reside in the memory of the unit. So
Any editing you make and save your presets that will go into the user area. Okay. And again, you've got 96 different slots here. Now, one thing I got to say is the graphics on the software is beautiful. The amps, if you right click on the amp, you've got 27 different amps. And when you click on these, it automatically loads the cab that's associated with that amplifier. And it gives you a great representation of the front panel of that amp. You've got different microphones here for the cab. You've got four different selections. And you've got three different positions. You've got edge, middle, and center. And the closer you move to the center, the brighter the sound is going to get. You put it on the edge, it'll be a more darker sound. All of these little switches work, and even the inputs here, you can select either input high or input low, and you see it will change there. So you've got all these different amps that the way they look, I mean, is just like the real deal. Again, here's the inputs. You've also got this power amp section where you have a bias setting and a level setting, and this bias setting can be used in a lot of different ways. It can be used to add. You see how the twos light up? It's pretty cool. Can be used to add or take away some of the hair, if you will, on any one of these particular amplifiers. Now, when you bring that bias down, the level's going to go down, so you can raise that up if you want. And now the cabs, you can mix and match these cabs. You've got 27 different included cab impulse responses that are included in the unit. Some of these are third party. Like, for example, if I click on this preset, you see right here, this is a third party IR. And that's also included in the unit. But the majority of these have the cab that or speaker simulation that's associated with the amp. But back to the amps here. We've got Jazz Clean, which is Roland Jazz Chorus. We've got several Fender simulations here. This is a nice looking one here. And here in the all of these switches here, the jumper settings, you have all of the jumper settings. Just like you would do on a regular amp. And again, this one has the bias and level control. So if we just go through the list here, we look at the Plexi, the Marshall simulations here. You've got the name of the amp and again, the associated cab. This one sounds pretty good, actually. Now, if you want to use your own third-party IRs, you can. If you hit right here, custom, and then you click on the cab, and you can import, you can load up to 32 different of your own third-party impulse responses. I have a few of mine loaded in here. I even have some of the other third-party. This one in particular is the third-party IR that comes with the unit. And some these other ones are all mine. But as you're playing, you can just click on these, and you see the everything will change. The EQ curve and everything, this is one of mine. This is the third-party one. See that, how the EQ curve will change? And you'll definitely hear a different sound. So that's pretty cool. You can have up to 32 different ones. Now, if we go back to the presets and back to some of the amps here, this is probably one of the better sounding amps. Now, I notice about the presets, I recognize some of these names. For one thing, Pete Thorne has some. Pete has eight solos in here. LT, I believe that's Leon Todd. Joko, I recognize this guy. He's got nine. And Vinay T, great guitar player. He's got some in here. Mike Hermans has some. Back in the day when he started doing videos, I think he went by Pop Into the Chemist. It was some cool videos that this guy made. And he's got, the presets here. So you have all of these that are included with the unit. Now I'm going to go through some of these sounds later. Some of them sound pretty darn good, which is usually when you buy a modeler, guitar modeler, processor, the factory presets that come with the unit leave a lot to be desired. I mean, we've been discussing that for years, why some of these companies do that. But this one has some great sounding presets right out of the box. And I'm going to play some of those for you. Now, here's your signal chain. Any one of these blocks can be moved around. You cannot put one between the amp and cab, but you can move them around any way you want. See? Now, the noise reduction, you only have one model. This is a noise gate. But again, when you click on it, doesn't that look familiar? Yeah, the graphics are going to look like something that you recognize. Now, in this one, the effects block, these are all compressors. And there's also a envelope filter and a wah. Okay. And you've got a pitch bender, like a whammy, you know. And I believe if you would have a expression pedal connected to the unit, you'll be able to control these. It's got a harmonious feature. That sounds pretty good. Now in the boost section, you've got this is a Katana, tube screamer, you know, blues driver, simulation of a Boss blues driver, and again, you'll recognize the graphics. So you've got seven different drive boost buttons here, boost models here. Again, the amps, 27 different amps, cabs, got 27 different cab models. Now you've got different EQs here. You can place these before the amp or after, whichever you decide. And we've got two different ones, a parametric and a 7-band. Now the parametric's cool because you can actually see the physical EQ curve and change the sound dramatically. All of these can be moved around left to right, and you'll hear the sound in real time as you change it. Now the mod section, you've got a lot of really cool modulation effects, the CE1 ensemble chorus back in the day was really hot. This one here is a TC chorus, and it sounds fabulous. I mean, they got the sound nailed for a lot of these different things. You've got a detune, give you that 80s, you know, 80s hair thing, and the shift left and shift right. I don't know if these are delayed, but in the real even tides, you could delay the left and the right side by just a few milliseconds. And you could set the depth. So I haven't played around with that one yet, but great sounding tremolo again, another Boss. This script Phase 90, which I'm sure you all recognize. Phase 100, again, the 4-stage phaser. And a Univibe, which is looks just like the Dunlop, the big, heavy metal Dunlop Univibe, which I used to have. But this thing weighed about, I don't know, 4 pounds, something like that. But they have all the models. And again, you know, you can use your mouse, and all of these work. You've got a send and return effects loop. You can run it in series or parallel or what they call branch. Usually you'd probably want to leave that in the serial mode. And then you've got a bunch of different reverbs. You've got spring, plate, room, and hall. The plate one sounds really cool, I found out. This hall one is it's like a model of a Lexicon. Very rich sounding reverb here. Then you've got your delays. You've got three different delays, an analog, a tape, and a digital delay. And if you do the digital delay, that's everybody knows what that looks like. Now right here, you have a setting where you could run the delay and the reverb in parallel, or you can run the delay into the reverb, and you can see it switches for you. or you can run the reverb into the delay, which I believe is what a lot of people like to do. Let's see. Now, up here, you can export a preset. Like, say if I want to export this preset, if I hit export, you select the preset you want to export. Say if it's this 3B one here. You select that, and then you hit the little export icon here. And you can save it wherever you want on your computer. Now, same way you can do this, you can import a preset. Now, if I go here, I've got a few presets here, GD Clean and GD Crunch, which I'll be demoing for you later on in this video. But you can import a preset. Just double-click on it. And then it'll ask you select a slot. And I'll just put it back in the same slot here. And you hit Import. And it'll tell you that it's been loaded successfully. See that? Now, on any preset you're on, if you whatever settings you make that you like, you can hit this button, which is just, it'll just save it as it is. Up here we have a settings menu that has your USB recording and playback levels. Now, I want to mention, when this is connected to your computer through USB, your audio is going to pass back through the unit into the outputs of the unit. So you're going to want to watch that playback level. This is your routing. You could do reamping, where it'll give you a clean sound for your guitar that you may want to use on different amp simulation software that's out there. You've got a MIDI information list with all the MIDI CC messages that you may need. And then it'll tell you the firmware. You've got whatever language. I would think this is English, Japanese, and Chinese right here. And the knobs, straight or round. Let's see, what does that do? I'm not sure. Okay, I'm not sure what that does. But that's, you know, it's in there. It says straight. I'm just put it back to straight because that's where they had it. So that's the software. Again, this looks really, really cool software. Great representations of all of these amps. There's the Matchless DC30. Of course, you've got all the classics AC30s here. Yeah, see that? There's the classic AC30 panel. So, okay, well, let me play a few of these presets. I'm not going to play every single one, because I don't want the video to be too long. I'm just going to skip through a few of them and let you hear what you get right out of the box. I haven't adjusted any of these except for these three that I made myself. But I'm gonna play some of them, the ones that I think are good. I'm just going to bounce through them. And then at the very end, I'll play my three. So let's take a look and see how this unit sounds right out of the box. And after that, I'll give you my conclusion.
Thank you. Okay, what's my conclusion? Well, I like it. I think for the price, $449, I believe, is what it is from the online retailers, that's US. This unit is very sturdy. And for what you get, the amount of amps, you know, 27 built-in amps, 27 built-in caps, 32 IR slots. There are units that cost twice as much as this that don't have that many IR slots. Now, do you need that many IR slots? Well, honestly, in a live situation, I only use one because when I go through my presets, I don't want the sound man to freak out. And when you change IRs like that in the middle of a song or something, it totally changes your sound that's dialed into to the PA. But it's nice to have to audition to find, go through some different IRs and find your sound. And also with the connections, the balanced XLR outs, it's great. You don't need a DI. Now, what I would do is go XLR out to the PA, and then I take these two lines and split them off to my on-stage amp. So it's always, most all the time, use an amp on stage. I could see me using this thing on fly dates because it's size is so small. It can fit in a knapsack. Heck, it could fit in my guitar case in the little pull-up thing, you know? So I think the guys at Nuex were smart, very smart, to price this unit at the price point that they did. And I hope they sell a ton of them. So I can see myself getting a lot of use out of this thing. So thank you guys over at Nuex. Now I'm going to do one more video where I'm going to show you how to use the unit hands-on. You don't need the software that I used in earlier in this video. You really don't need that. You know, you can do everything you need to do from the unit itself. So I'm going to show you that in my next video and do one of my backing tracks that, you know, I always love to do and create some new original music and play this thing in a mix so you can get to hear it. Okay, so guys, I hope you enjoyed this long, drawn-out video. And again, thank you from the wonderful people over at Nuex Effects. I'll leave a link to their website at the end of this video. Thank you guys for watching. Until I see you again, rock on.